evening and welcome, and thank you for coming out to a live concert. I'm Lorna Peters, the director of Sinfonia Spirituosa, and it's almost impossible to tell you how happy this ensemble is to be here again, performing in this exquisite recital hall. I want to thank UC Davis, Phil Daly, and his wonderful team here at the Pitzer. And Stephen Bingen, an exceptionally fine recording engineer. The first time Sinfonia Spirituosa was reunited since February of 2020 was about 6 weeks ago, when 12 of us flew to San Antonio, Texas for a four-day residency at Trinity University. It was made extra special by the fact that this residency had been planned for over 2 years and canceled twice because of COVID. In addition to lots of lovely rehearsal time in their gorgeous Parker Chapel, we had a very busy schedule working with Trinity's music students, teaching 7 master classes, coaching chamber music, and giving private lessons. On the final night, we presented a concert to the first live audience that chapel had seen in 2 years. A central aim of the residency was a collaboration with choral director Gary Zygmunt's award-winning chamber singers on a motet by French Baroque composer Michel Richard de Lalande. Our strong embrace of French music in our return this spring includes an interesting connection. You might notice that the composer of the next piece is Jean-Baptiste Lully Fil. He was a French musician and the second son of Jean-Baptiste Lully. In 1696, he became the superintendent, sounds better in French, of the music of the king, a position that he shared with Michel Richard de Lalande until 1719. The title of his piece that we'll perform next, Music for the King's Supper. If you know Sinfonia, you probably know that all the members are superb teachers and that we are committed to sharing our exploration of this repertoire with those who are perhaps a bit newer to it but curious about broadening their experience. To that end, we have, from day one, had a mentorship program. For this California set of concerts, we are thrilled to have violist Bree McCullough as our mentorship participant. Joining us from Los Angeles, where she is currently working on a graduate degree in ethnomusicology at the University of California. And finally, the Telemann, which will end the first half of this concert, is a work that I've wanted to do for a very long time. So I was thrilled when our cellist, gombist Ava Limonstall, responded with a resounding and enthusiastic yes when I asked her if she'd be interested in performing it with us this season. I first heard this piece and fell in love with it on a CD from 2002 by the groundbreaking early music ensemble Musica Antiqua Krohn. Interestingly, the gamba soloist on that CD is Jaap ter Linden, Ava's teacher when she was a student at the Royal Conservatory of The Hague. So coming full circle, that CD is also the first place where I heard our namesake piece, Telemann's Sinfonia Spirituosa.
Thank you. Thank you.
So you may ask, why all the French music? Well, I like it, and I'm the director. Well, that's part of it. But I have found that an excellent way for the group to develop is on a steady diet of French music. Maybe not French food, French music, right? So not to say that Bach and Handel and Vivaldi are not challenging, and that we would always strive to see that music as well in a new light. But we all grew up with that music. So there's a big head start there. Not so much the case with French music, where what you end up producing and hearing is often very, very different from what you see written on the page of music in front of you. As is the case in both the Lully and the Rameau we're about to play, there are multiple individual parts, not just first, second violin, viola, and basses. The resultant textures and colors are a hallmark of this French music to Debussy and beyond. Balancing and hearing these multiple instrumental lines while playing, communicating the rhythmic subtleties of the French language, and the demands of the ornamentation push us to listen to each other with a capital L. Balancing the freedom inherent in French music with the artistry needed to actually play together develops the strong bond of trust between players that is essential in a conductorless ensemble. Again, thank you so much for coming out to a live concert, coming to hear us this evening and support us in our California tour. I also wanted to mention that the Rameau we would like to play without applause, so if you could just hold it until the end, that would be great. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.